This is KOAT7 Albuquerque. Now, New Mexico's number one balloon fiesta team. Action 7 News presents live coverage of the 1998 Balloon Fiesta Mass Ascensions. Today's special presentation is brought to you by Isleta Gaming Palace. Now, live from Balloon Fiesta Park, your hosts, Nelson Martinez, Diane Anderson, and Dick Nipping.
Muy buenos dias.
Good morning to you.
Good morning, Dick. He's out there in the corners.
I'm here in the cold. Hi, Nelson.
He's out there. He'll join us a little bit later on. Good morning. Welcome to the 27th annual Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta. It's gorgeous out here, and the atmosphere is just a sizzling.
But if you're back home, you probably have about the best seat in the house, because you can sit there in your jammies and drink your coffee.
Yep.
And watch from all different points of view, because we have Sky 7, we have our cherry picker camera, we have people on the scene, out on the field, off the field, you name it, we have people all around. All our photographers, all of our team members are out here to bring you the best show around.
You know, over the years that we've been doing this, and we say at the end or the last weekend, oh, thank goodness this is over. I don't want to see it again. You know, you get a little tired, but nope. Come again this morning. It's electrical out here. It's absolutely beautiful. Love it.
Well, someone who's been coming to this for all of the 27 years it's been around, in fact, he helped get the first one going.
Yeah.
Tom Rutherford is out in the field to give us his unique perspective. Tom?
Good morning. We're going to have lots of interesting shots and interesting interviews. The weather couldn't be better for balloon flying. The zebras are here with me, and they're ready to get going. How long before the first balloon?
They're saying about 15 to 20 minutes. They got to inflate and stuff like that.
And is the weather just ideal?
We got the boxing effect today, and it should be good to go.
It's Kodak Day at the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta. We'll be bringing you reports from the field all morning.
Isn't that very cool? This is where all those adjectives surface when you start seeing the phenomenal.
You kind of run out of things to describe it. You almost have to be out here. And when you tell people who are not from Albuquerque about the Balloon Fiesta, they go, oh, yeah, I've been to some Balloon Fiesta. You haven't been to this one. It is different from any of the others because it's bigger and better, and it gets that bigger and better every year.
It's kind of nice to see the reaction from people who are here for the very first time. You can tell. You can see them, you know, already, even before the balloons come out, they're just wandering about in wonderment and happy. This is a very happy atmosphere. Good.
We're expecting 850 hot air balloons representing 41 states and 16 countries over the next 9 days. But first, in order to get out here and see all those balloons and meet all those people, you have to get through the traffic.
Oh, yeah.
And that's where our Dan Monahan is this morning, now giving us a report on how things are going. Dan?
Dan
Monahan's. Well, maybe they're not going that well.
There he is.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We're at the corner of Tramway, just off the I-25 exit. I'm going to give you a look at what the traffic's doing here right now. This is a pretty good line still for this time of the day. The sun is up and some of the balloons are up, and these people are having to watch through their windshield because they're not to the park yet. Now, if you're going to drive out to the park still, you can still make it, but you might miss a little bit of the early risers out here. We got to let you know that if you're coming off I-25, do not get off at Paseo, do not get off at Alameda, get off at the Tramway exit. Whether you're north or southbound on I-25, get off at the Tramway exit. And all the sheriff's deputies out here will direct you into the park. If you're coming from the west side, anywhere west of the field, and you want to come in from there, come in Alameda, and again, they will direct you to the parking on the field. There is always the option of not driving at all, aside from staying home and watching our coverage, of course. You could take a bus out to catch the balloons. That would be the park and ride, and the new offering this year from the Beach Water Park, which is not a park and ride, but it is a similar operation for all the days of Fiesta. You know, those park and ride operations run from all of the malls, Cottonwood, Winrock, and Coronado, and they'll run on the weekend mornings for all of these mass ascensions. And the one from the Beachwater Park this year is running every day for every event, as I understand it. That's $6.50 in any case for an adult, and that does include the $4 admission charge to the park for adults. And there are different breaks in the prices for seniors and kids with a paying adult and things like that. But if you're gonna buy a ticket, you need to take the cash, and I would take correct change, to the place on the morning and make sure that you've got enough money to get everybody there, because you'd hate to leave somebody in the park and have them miss this. Those, in case you're wondering, are not hot air balloons. Those are taking off from Coronado Airport here on tramway. I think they're trying to get out before the balloons get in their way. They got some flying to do today that the balloons could block if they fly our way. Right now, we don't have any balloons in sight at all except for one just on horizon, so they're not really... That's also not a balloon. That's the Bud Airship, a blimp that's flying around us today. We're going to hang out here, see where the balloons go, and we're going to chase them, guys. Meanwhile, you let us know when they start leaving the field, and we'll start running after them.
All right. Thank you, Dan. Looks like there is one or two up there. I think they might be left over from the the Dawn Patrol, which goes up about 5:30 every morning. And that's interesting for those of us who get up really early and come out here on the field to get to see a few of the, about a dozen, I guess, of the best flyers around go up in the pre-dawn moments.
And as we heard the field official, one of them a while ago, said that the box is perfect. It's in effect. That's the combination of the upper and lower level winds created by the beautiful Sandia Mountains, enhanced by the Rio Grande. So it's going to be nice. The balloons go up, and then they'll catch the other wind going the other direction, and they should get their money's worth today.
And that's exactly why so many of them come here. And Joe Diaz is out in the field to tell us how it's going out there, Joe.
Well, we're part of the first wave going up over here. In fact, you look behind us, you can see the Channel 7 balloon getting ready to take off. It's in the cold inflation process. You know, there are like 870 balloons entered in this year's Fiesta, representing something like 20% of all registered balloons in the world. People come from far and wide, including Steve Derby. Now, you're from where, Steve?
From Crystal Lake, Illinois.
Now, there's a neat... you brought your own...
The Crystal Lake contingent!
Crew with you here. Now, sure, Steve, there's a neat story with your balloon, because you see this basket? No one's ever ridden in it before. This burner's never been fired before. This envelope's...
Just a test flight.
You did one test flight.
One test flight.
Okay,
yeah.
But a brand new balloon.
Brand new balloon. We picked it up at the factory in Sioux Falls, South Dakota from Aerostar on Tuesday of this week.
That's pretty neat. So this is your first time flying, obviously, right?
Well.
any takers to go up with? No, you've been flying for several years. Tell me the name.
Actually, I've been flying for about 20 years.
Great. And tell me the name of your balloon.
The name of the balloon is Got the Hots.
So what's it look like?
You're just going to have to see it to believe it.
So it is something to behold, then, right?
Something to behold, yeah.
Okay, now, you were telling me that the Balloon Fiesta is kind of special to you because that's where you met your wife?
My wife and I met here in 1991, and we got married in the balloon that I had before, and we're back. This is our Wednesday is our 7th anniversary.
Okay, well, so tell me what you're doing right now and what we're going to see over the next few minutes.
Well, we're just getting everything laid out. We've got a ground sheet here, and we've laid the balloon out. We've put everything together, and we're getting ready to... attach things so that we don't go flying before we want to, and then we're going to light the burners and take off with everybody else.
Okay, Steve, we'll be checking in with you periodically. He's going up in wave one, Steve Derby from the Chicago area, and he'll be, what's the name of your balloon again?
Got the hot.
So we'll see what it looks like when it's inflated in just a bit. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Joe.
That's a pretty cool story. Seven years.
One of the fun things about coming out here, you grab a program and look around at the names. They come up with some very creative names for the different balloons. And, of course, the special shapes always have some good ones, too.
Lots of names. We're going to mention some of those pretty soon. But in the meantime, as we remind you for the very first time this morning that you are watching a live broadcast from Albuquerque Balloon Fiesta Field, the new one, just north of Alameda. And it's filling up, as it usually does.
The balloons are cold inflating, getting ready for the mass ascension, and we will be back with more of our live coverage in just a moment. And we are back live out at Balloon Fiesta Park as the balloons are just getting ready to take off on the first wave of the mass ascension. You know, one of the things about staying home and watching it from the point of view that you're seeing it is you get to see it from a lot of different angles, and one of those is Sky 7, right up there along with the balloons every morning. Let's go up with Mike Sims, who's up in Sky 7 this morning. Hi, Mike.
Hey, good morning, Diane and Nelson. You know, this is the best seat in the house. I got to envy you guys down on the field, but we can have a bird's eye view from Sky 7 up here. Here's the first picture of the first wave as they get ready to take off. You know, just a few minutes ago, these guys were completely on the ground, and now we see the cold inflation is going on. Like you said, the first wave is about to take off. Of course, the balloons that took off in the Dawn Patrol have been up for over an hour, and they just keep circling in the Albuquerque box. The winds are blowing them back and forth across the balloon field. This is a great view, as you can see traffic is moving in, people are down on the field, and the first wave is getting ready to take off in just a few minutes. Back to you guys.
That's pretty outstanding. From where we sit here on the set on the Albuquerque Balloon Fiesta field, we can see you, Sky 7, hovering over the Sandia Mountains, and yet you have that picture.
And with that great camera, you can zoom right in and really give us a great point of view.
That's amazing. Technology, huh? The marvel of electronics and the marvel of these flying things. I prefer one with a motor on it myself, but anyway, these are nice. Nice to watch. Have you ever taken a balloon ride, Diane?
I have. I've been up twice, and I really enjoyed it. It's been a few years. Right after I came to Albuquerque, I went up once, and the second one of my balloon rides was one of those with the rough landings where they drag the gondola around.
Yeah,
my husband
scary.
And I went up. Actually, before we got married, and I don't think he'll be going back up, but I liked it a lot.
It's kind of an experience when the wind is, as you're floating or just about ready to hit, make contact with the ground when you're landing, you have to brace yourself. It can get a little, I don't want to alarm anybody, but you got to be on your guard.
It's exciting, put it
this,
that way.
This is the sound all over the park this morning. Let me see if you can hear it.
Sipping coffee.
It's good.
Slurping coffee. In your case.
The aroma, I've always said this year after year, you can't beat it. Matter of fact, last night, my wife and I came down through here, and we were walking around, and no one here but the vendors doing last-minute things, but you could still catch the aroma of some of the preparations for this morning. Oh, and it still smells great.
That's one of the things you miss out on when you're at home. You can't grab a breakfast burrito or a cinnamon bun or a big, I guess you could fix some coffee, but.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you took the easy way out this year. I mean, I left home at 4:45 this morning. I live over on the west side and came down Paseo and in through that way. But you slept in your RV.
I'm telling
you. And walked here at 6:30 this morning. So you got 2 more hours sleep. So I'll just let you take the last hour by yourself and I'll go take a nap.
I'll be less punchy, huh? No, you know, it's my first year RVing, as they say. And now I understand why Albuquerque, this time of year, is host to so many RVers, and welcome. This is just the way to go. There are thousands of RVs out and about, and beautiful mm-hmm. machines. And so my wife and I came down here last night and overnighted. It's beautiful. What a convenience. What a convenience.
Now you see some of the first balloons going up in the first wave, and we have a couple of people standing by to give us their perspective, an honored guest and our own Dick Niffing. Good morning, Dick.
Good morning, Diane. I'm out here with the mayor of Albuquerque, a former Action 7 newsman. Many years ago, he and I covered these balloons when they were first starting up. You remember those days?
Oh, I do. I've got a photograph at home of me with an old Bell & Howell film camera and a balloon, 1972 or something. And who would have thought it would have turned into something like this? I came in on a plane last night from Seattle, Dick, and it was full of people coming to the balloon races. And I think a large part of the credit for that goes to a former mayor named Harry Kinney.
Harry got the city
who had the vision, and I worked for him at that time, and I was on the charter board of directors of this thing, and we put a little bit of money into it, as seed money, the city. It was controversial at that time, but look what it's done, and the gross receipts tax and lodgers tax we get off this is incredible now.
Does any city anywhere in the country have anything like this?
No, not at all, and I was at a board meeting of the Wilderness Society up in Seattle, and they said, why are you going back early? And I said, I got to go open the Balloon Fiesta. And they said, oh, that's the biggest one in the world, isn't it? Everybody knows it. And so we're really on the map with this thing.
Yeah, I was talking to Tom Rutherford this morning. Of course, Tom, one of the founders of this thing. And I said, is there anything that approaches this, any other balloon event? And he said, not even close.
No, it's not even close. This number of balloons staggered us. I mean, those first few years, I think we were really excited because we had like 120 balloons.
Yeah, remember that?
Yeah.
120, 200, now
yeah,
we have 800.
Now we have 800 some odd, and it's like confetti falling out of the sky almost, you know.
What does the city put into this, Jim?
Well, the city provides a lot of services. They're providing this balloon site for one. You know, the city owns this balloon site, and we're going to do a lot of things with it to make it a year-round sort of venue. But, you know, you see a lot of police officers out here. You see our buses. The buses are full of people today, and that's what I would suggest. People come out
park
on the buses. It's really fast. I came in on the bus route, and it's really good. We provide some city services out here. We fill the holes in the ground and all this sort of stuff. So, but it's paid for. I mean, our police are not costing us overtime. That's paid for by the Balloon Fiesta.
And this is a great thing for Albuquerque, not only in terms of the tax revenues we get out of it, but just for the publicity and the overall impact.
Yeah, it's probably the most envious Chamber of Commerce kind of deal you could have. And you know what, Dick? It takes care of, it really takes advantage of the best thing we got going for us, and that's our climate. Our climate in Albuquerque is just about the best in the world, and it takes advantage of it. We should do more of this outside stuff.
Best time of the year, and a whole lot of fun. Mayor Baca, thanks for being with us.
Thanks, Dick.
Okay, back to you, Diana Nelson.
Thanks. You guys.
Mayor Jim Baca, I'm good friends with his twin brother, Tom, lives in our neighborhood.
Oh.
Nice man, and a pilot for one of the cable companies. Oh, he just goes all over the place. Let's see. I'll bet you we are due for some incredible information, because this person definitely has it up, stored up in that little computer of his. Let's go to one of the founders. He and Sid Cutter, many, 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 many years ago, put it together. Here is the, I guess it's reasonable to call him one of the fathers of this balloon fiesta. Tom Rutherford, how are you, sir? Good morning to you.
Good morning. It's a beautiful day out at Balloon Fiesta Park. The Kodak balloons have lifted off carrying the American flags while the Rio Rancho High School Band played the national anthem. Then the World Balloon Corporation ride balloons began to lift off. People are out here taking their first ever balloon ride with the pilots of World Balloon Corporation. And then the first wave is going to start. Now, Nelson, you talked about wishing that you had aircraft with motors on them. And so I found you a balloon pilot that does that too, although he flies powered paragliders. This is Ray Shady from Truckee, California.
Wow.
How do those work?
Well, you have a motor that you put on your back and a paragliding wing. You inflate the wing and you run a few steps and you're in the air.
So that's sort of what you were talking about, Nelson, isn't it? For real fun, Ray flies the Flying Turtle Balloon in Truckee, California. Now, this is in a beautiful valley in the mountains near Reno, isn't it?
Yeah, just north of Lake Tahoe, about 30 miles west of Reno, Nevada.
Site of the former Olympic, Winter Olympic site.
Yeah, about 15 miles from Squaw Valley.
It must be beautiful there. But you don't fly in the midst of 800 balloons there, do you?
No, I'm usually out there with maybe myself or one other.
Yeah. Well, Ray is going to be part of the mass ascension in a few minutes. They're just about to cold inflate the balloon. We'll kind of watch it as it goes up. As you can maybe see over my shoulder, the Channel 7 balloon is getting ready to go into the air, too. So the first wave is about to begin as soon as these ride balloons are finished lifting off. It's a great day at the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta.
Thank you, Tom, and we are back out at the Balloon Fiesta as the first wave is about to get underway. We understand the Albuquerque box is working perfectly this morning, so a lot of the people who live around the Balloon Fiesta Park will be in store for a treat as they can sit out on their back porches and watch the balloons. We had two of them land in our pasture in front of our house last year, and that was a thrill for the kids to get to see the balloons come down. And you know, one of the things that's so nice is the chase crews who follow these balloons are really nice groups. They always say, hey, can we land? They usually ask before they do, and we're like, sure, come on down. You're seeing a beautiful shot from Sky 7. It started really tight down right where you could see where we are with our little setup here, or a big setup here, and then it pulls out to give you a view, an overall view of Balloon Fiesta Park and beyond.
And as they said earlier, the box is perfect this morning, that combination of upper and lower level winds. So the balloonists, and I've been watching a few, at a certain level, the lower level are going south, the higher level going back north. It's just perfect.
The reason they like that so well, and of course people who've been in this area know this by heart, but that's because they can come back and land very close to where they took off. The chase crews don't have to try to find some route to go find them somewhere off where they're not sure where they are. So it makes it real convenient. They can come back many times and land right on Balloon Fiesta Field.
Yep, and all they have to do is change elevations. And they do that just by giving it a little air or just letting it cool off. Simple as that. And Tom said a while ago that some of them are cold inflating, and for those, that's a very simple operation. They get that giant fan as they hold, the crew holds the envelope, and they let that air get in there. It kind of poofs it up a little, and then they give it a good blast of hot air, and bingo.
Off it takes.
We're going to see several brand new shapes this year that are joining the Balloon Fiesta. Something that is just inflating behind us is the Canadian Mounted Patrol. It's a new one, and we're going to get lots of looks at that one later.
One of about a dozen new special shapes among the 80 special shapes that will be here during the special shapes rodeo, and some of them take off during the mass ascensions too. Let's go back out on the field. You know, that's one of the nicest things about this event as compared to so many is you get to get right out there in the middle of it. You're not stuck up in a stadium somewhere watching it from afar, and Joe Diaz is out among the crowd. Joe?
Oh yeah, this is really a great place to be. This is the Got the Hots balloon on its maiden voyage. They picked it up at the factory just a little bit ago. Let's see if we can sneak in here and talk to Steve. Steve, I guess you're in the cold inflation process right now. What have you been doing? You've been doing the pre-flight and all that?
Been doing the pre-flight, pulling all the fabric out. We've got this fan running, putting all the cold air into the balloon. And right now we're just about to burn the burners and stand it up.
Okay, so you're going to start the burners right now? Yeah, sure.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, so the burners are on, and there's the Got the Hots balloon. It's a brand new balloon. You kind of see it with the sunglasses and the smiley face. And Steve is firing the burners right into the air, right into the envelope there. And he tells me that it's just a few seconds before he'll start to stand up over here. So he's laying on the tarp right now. The propane's going in. And there he goes. He's starting to lift up into a vertical position. The crew likes it. Okay, there you go, Steve Derby. He's from the Chicago, Illinois area. This is the first time that the balloon is really flown in an official function. And there he goes. Let's go ahead and talk to some of the crowd right now. Where are you from?
Albuquerque.
So you've seen this all before, right?
Uh-huh, every year.
So how was the traffic when you came in today?
It was good. We left really early, left about 5 o'clock. Got him right before the rush.
Okay, good. Are you guys getting good pictures this morning?
I hope we are. I don't know.
Where are you from?
Santa Maria, California.
Is this your first Fiesta?
Yes, it is.
So what do you think about this?
Oh, we're really excited. It's been great so far.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, this is the most photographed balloon event in the world, or I guess it's the most photographed event in the world. Let's go ahead and talk to Steve one more time. Steve, how long do you think before you actually get the okay to lift off out of here?
We got all these other balloons out here to take off, and they're taking off from both ends, so it's kind of hard to say. We wait for the launch directors to come, and as soon as they say it's ready to go, we go.
But everything looks okay.
Everything looks just great.
Okay,
great
well,
morning.
We'll check back with you. Maybe we can catch you lifting off out of here. Okay, Steve Derby from the Chicago, Illinois area. Getting ready to launch from the Got the Hots balloon. Nelson and Diane, back to you.
Okay, thank you, Joe. And it's good for Joe to be back. He's, you know, was here several years ago out covering Balloon Fiesta, and this is his first year back to check it out again. The big royal Mountie that we saw just a minute ago is about to go up, and this is his kind of debut of the New Mexico's Fiesta. He's actually celebrating the Canadian Royal Mounted Police, who are 125 years old this year. There he is. The big balloon.
Well, he did have to face that way. we'll turn him around somewhere. But that is another one of those shapes that are just
it's from Canada, and it joins, you can see just on the other side of his right arm is a little kind of a shape of a Canadian maple leaf, which is we've seen from several years here. That's part of the tourism from Canada, their effort to bring in and get everybody to kind of come up their way and visit.
Yep.
Well, speaking of tourism, we've got a special guest with Dick Niffing now.
All right, thank you, Diane. We have with us a man who has a vested interest in this operation and all of the people who come here for it, John Garcia, New Mexico Secretary of Tourism. Thanks, Mr. Secretary.
Oh, good morning, Dick. Great to be here.
Isn't it great fun being out here in the middle of all this stuff?
Oh, I'm the biggest fan.
Yeah, we're right in back of the mountain, Diane and Nelson. We're talking about all these other special shapes that are just gearing up out here right now. How important is the Balloon Fiesta to New Mexico?
Oh, it's very big. Millions of people come visit and spend their money. It's great for the economy. But it's just great for Albuquerque and the whole state of New Mexico.
Now, as an old restaurateur, I'm sure you're happy to see all these people out here eating all this food this morning.
Breakfast burritos, 5:30 this morning. I was first one in line. It was great.
That's a tough business, but balloons help all of that, don't they?
Oh, and it's great. It's a good event, good for Albuquerque, New Mexico. A lot of people get involved. My kids just love it, so it's great.
What is the impact of the Balloon Fiesta beyond the fiesta itself?
Well, you know, all year round, we promote it. We do trade shows all around the world, and so we talk about the Balloon Fiesta everywhere we go. And people know about it everywhere around the country, East Coast, England, Europe. So it's a real big part of New Mexico worldwide, really.
You're saying sometimes they just bring it up spontaneously when they know that you're from New Mexico.
Absolutely. They've seen pictures of it. It's the most photographed event in the world, and right here in Albuquerque, New Mexico.
How much would it cost the state of New Mexico to buy that kind of publicity?
Couldn't buy it. And we love it. And there's media from all over the world. We had a great party last night with them, and a couple of weeks of great fun.
All right, John, thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
All right, our coverage, live coverage of this 1998 International Balloon Fiesta, the Kodak International Balloon Fiesta, continues in just a moment.
Action 7 News Balloon Fiesta cover.
Good morning again and welcome back out to the live coverage of the Balloon Fiesta from KOAT 7. And that sun has just peeped up over the Sandias. We're blinded, but it sure does make those balloons look nice. It just brings out all the color against that beautiful blue New Mexico sky.
Are you hungry?
Well, I've already had a breakfast burrito, but I'm saving room for later too.
Oh, I mean, the aroma is just wonderful. I keep talking about that because you can't take that in at home, not yet anyway. They're working on it, you know. But it smells, now it smells like hotcakes or you know, those pancakes or something.
Pancakes, yeah. Oh. Yes. Or maybe funnel cakes. That's
funnel cakes.
Might be what it is as well. It
smells good.
Well, Joe Diaz is, he's back out on the field, but let's go and find out what Tom Rutherford has found. He's on the field as well, and of course, Tom brings us his 27 years of perspective of being out among the balloons. Tom, what are you doing out there?
Well, I'm here with Mike Kelly, recently of San Diego, who is assembling the balloon basket, and I thought it would be interesting to see what they go through. Now, these are the uprights, and that's like plastic pipe or something. What's all this made of?
This is a nylon type material, and these are the supports for the burner system up here on top, and it's flexible to give more flex to the system to make it easier when you come in for landings.
And now this is aircraft cable, isn't it?
Yeah, this is the aircraft cable. This is actually the suspension. This is not the rod is not the suspension system. Actually, the balloon attaches to the carabiner here, and then the loads are transmitted down to the steel cable underneath the basket.
Now this is the stuff that holds like DC-10s together, isn't it? That's good, strong cable.
Yeah, the one cable is enough to hold the entire balloon together.
Okay, now this is the burner system up above us,
yes,
and you were just testing that. And why are there two handles? I only see one burner.
The two handles here?
Yeah.
This is a redundant system in that I have two fuel tanks, and each fuel tank has its own hose, and it's one burner, but actually it's two burners in one. This is a separate fuel system. Each side has its separate fuel system.
How many gallons of fuel will you carry up today?
30 gallons, 15 in each tank.
And how long will that last on a day like this?
Approximately 2 hours.
And does the altitude matter here? You're from San Diego. Do you fly longer at the sea level or?
Well, that's a density altitude. It's more dense at lower down. Up here, you will use a little bit more fuel, yeah.
That was a good answer. And there's an instrument panel in here that measures the temperature at the top of the balloon and the altitude and the rate of climb. Is that right?
Yes, it does.
And you're going to be in the second wave, so we'll watch you lift off. What's the name of the balloon?
Primary Dream.
And what's it look like, so we'll know what to watch for?
It's half red, and then with a yellow and blue stair step going up around the balloon in a spiral.
We're watching the balloons get ready. Some are being assembled, some are being inflated, and some are lifting off at the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta.
Thank you, Tom. Now, I see some different shapes that I haven't seen before. Of course, we've already talked about Mountie, but also there's Mrs. Butterworth.
Yeah, Mrs. Butterworth.
For the syrup.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And look at the turtle back there. It's a regular, shaped like a regular balloon, only he's got about 4 little feet and a head hanging down. Isn't that cute?
We'll see it later. Looks like we're... No, we're seeing
there's
Mrs. Butterworth.
There's Mrs. Butterworth.
Yep.
There'll be about a dozen new special shapes this year, including a rubber ducky, the Mountie, the Royal Canadian Mounted Officer that we've seen, Tweety, a bullseye barbecue, which has three sets of horns protruding from a balloon, Uniroyal has a mammoth tire, and there's the turtle we were talking about. Isn't he cute? There'll also be a Miss Daisy.
What's he advertising?
And a bumblebee, and a big bottle of French Chateau. So there's all kinds of stuff coming up.
You know, that's the thing about this balloon fiesta. As John Garcia was saying, you can't buy this advertising. And the folks that sponsor these balloons know that indeed.
But they do buy that advertising.
What is the turtle advertising? Take it slow or something, you know? I don't know.
That's a pretty one that's going over there. There's pink and has all the southwestern scenes on it.
Look at that color on that one there. Oh, isn't that beautiful?
We have a lot of different ways to bring you the different scenes. We've already seen from shots from Sky 7 this morning. We have two cherry pickers here at our location. There's a bluff cam that gives you a distance view, and a lot of people stand out on that little bluff, which is just to the east of the Balloon Fiesta field, and view or take pictures or video from that point of view. And then also we'll have our KOAT camera, balloon cam, which will be going up in just a few minutes. Right behind our set is Little Buck from Norwest Bank, and that's where our camera crew will be.
Even the air gets to the tail. I was noticing a minute ago the tail was starting to go.
You think that's a dollar bill hanging out of the back of his pocket there? I mean, he is a bank balloon.
And after all, he's there to encourage kids to save money, a dollar a day or something, anything. And before they know it, they're going to have thousands of dollars in their savings account. Save your money. It buys your freedom.
Well, Little Buck and his sister balloon, Miss Penny, are two of Albuquerque's home-based special shapes. There's also that Great Expectations, you know, the big stork. That's an Albuquerque special shape.
Yeah.
And there are a lot of them. 80 special shapes, and we'll see all of those during the Mass Ascension, the special shapes Mass Ascension later in the day.
Mm-hmm.
Later in the week.
Later in the week. Boy, this is perfect. Look at this weather.
You know, it seems a little bit warmer this year. I don't know.
Yes, it is.
It always gets the coolest right before the sun comes up.
And again, this is so perfect as far as the box goes. There are balloons that are just lifting are immediately heading south at a very comfortable pace. And then the ones that are probably 500 feet up, I would guess, are going north.
All the locals know what the Albuquerque box is, but if you haven't heard about it before, if you're visiting, let's get meteorologist Joe Diaz to explain it.
Is known simply as the Albuquerque box, sort of an atmospheric gift that keeps balloon pilots coming back for more.
It's like Mother Nature has given you a steering wheel. You can drive that balloon nearly any place you want to go.
As air falls down the nearby mountains, it flows toward the river, causing a gentle south wind. A balloon can launch and ride the wind in that southerly direction. Then the pilot can fire up the burners and lift to a higher altitude. At that level, the winds blow to the north, allowing the balloonist to move back toward the field. Then it's just a matter of dropping back to a lower level, and you're back to where you started.
What's cool is in Albuquerque, when you're flying the box and you really got it, some mornings you can come in and land within feet of where you took off. I have a classic picture from years ago where my father, my brother, and I landed the balloon in the back of the pickup truck.
Of course, everything has to be just right for a good box to kick in. So during Fiesta Week, the big question is weather. It has to be ideal. No rain, no snow. Yes, it's rare, but it has happened. But more often than not, the focus is the wind. How much is too much? Pretty much anything over a 10-knot wind.
After all, this is not destination travel. We're going out for a flight of fancy. There's no point in challenging what Mother Nature provides, so if it isn't just right, we don't fly. You can always wait another day.
Bottom line, I guess you would say the Balloon Fiesta is not like the post office. It does not operate during rain, sleet, or snow, but it does deliver. Always delivering a lot of color, a lot of excitement, and a lot of oohs and ahs. Joe Diaz, Action 7 News.
All right, information, now you've got it all. And that box, again, that unique relationship of mountain formations and wind characteristics, which keeps bringing balloonists back to Albuquerque year after year. This is number 27.
And it is working. What a great way to start off the Fiesta, is with the box working just so much that you can almost see a balloon and trace the box as you watch each individual balloon go up and over.
They're smiling.
We're going to get a balloon's view here in just a second. Little Buck is about to go up, and he will carry our Action 7 News balloon cam and photographer up with him and let you see what it's like to actually be up in a balloon, the next best thing to doing it yourself.
You know, another nice seat to have is hovering above this whole thing and out of the way, because FAA regulations dictate they have to stay way far away. But with our beautiful camera on board, we're going to show you what Mike Sims is seeing and hear his perspective. Hi, Mike.
Hi, Nelson, again. You know, the sun is just peeking over the San Dias to the east. Now the full sun is hitting those colors as the balloons come up off the field. It's just a beautiful sight. I'll tell you this, you guys are taking and seeing live pictures as we see them through television cams, but we also have still cameras up here in Sky 7. Pilot Jeff Martin, photographer Brian Pearson, and myself, all three of us have still cameras. We've just been having a great time taking still photographs from up here. You can see what we're seeing through the eyes of Sky 7 cam. We've seen a few splashes and dashes in the river. We've also seen all of these balloons in the first wave take off and, like you said, head south at the lower altitude and then go up and then come back north over the field at the higher altitude. Really is, to coin a phrase or to borrow a phrase, picture perfect. Back to you guys.
Have you, the first few years you go to the Balloon Fiesta, you take probably four or five rolls of film and then you get them home, and all the pictures are great, but they're all just pictures of balloons after balloons after balloons. You keep going, why did I take so many pictures? It's because you get so caught up in the majesty and the beauty of all these colors around you, and you're just, everywhere you look is a great snap.
It's good to also study those faces that are up there looking at this thing, and you, again, you definitely can tell who's here for the first time.
The little turtle balloon that we saw earlier, the pilot just hit a burst of hot air and his little head just popped right up, and then it went back down again. We're about to see Mountie take off along with the Canadian Leaf.
And there's our banner over the
Maple
balloon.
Leaf.
Our balloon, Action 7 News.
Uh-huh. We have two balloons that bear our banner and another one that carries our camera.
And then we've got all kinds of people dancing to the side. I don't know if our camera angle can catch up right by our set. We've got
balloons that don't go up.
They're dancing.
Now that's unusual. I haven't seen that before. You see all kinds of things out here. You see a lot of different outfits. Some really funny hats. Of course, the zebra outfits are always outlandish. Those are the people who actually direct the launching of the different balloons. And as Nelson said, there's some people who have just kind of decided to do a little jig out beside the station.
Yeah, it's probably out of our camera angle there. But anyway, oh yeah, somebody said, in response to how the Kodak people say this is the most photographed event in the world and more than a million pictures taken, somebody said they ought to hire how do they know that? How do they know it's a million pictures? Because people come in with their own rolls of film. They take it somewhere else to get developed. It's a different thing. Somebody said this year they're hiring a flash counter.
Oh, I don't think there's any disputing it.
Yeah, that's true. It's just everywhere you turn. There goes the Mountie.
Do you hear the applause from the crowd?
Let's listen.
This is his American debut, his U.S. debut. He came down from Canada.
There he goes.
To go off
still insisting on
showing
us the derriere. Put it kindly.
Maybe he'll turn around as he goes
up. That is huge. What are the statistics on this guy over here? He's like 200 and some thousand cubic feet.
Well, the Royal Canadian Mounted Police is who he is obviously representing, and it is their 125th year anniversary. And that's why they put him together to promote Canadian tourism. And of course, it's he was commissioned in May, so this is really a brand new balloon. Huge.
He is. It is. Whatever. Just amazing.
And he's quite a crowd pleaser. And another crowd pleaser is Little Buck as he lifts off right behind our set here with our camera. There you go. We'll be able to get you some views from the camera in the basket or the gondola of Little Buck. There you can see it. Now you're going along for a balloon ride. There's a shoestring hanging down. And you get a look at Mountie in the foreground. And a look at the crowd down below.
You hear the announcer in the background, the field announcer. I heard him at 4:35 this morning, something like that.
Is that your alarm clock?
That was the alarm clock, and the park came alive.
Look at the people. Isn't it amazing how many people get up at the crack, well, before dawn, before the crack of dawn?
The true meaning of unbelievable, that everybody comes out of here. And as we pass some of the concession stands, and there are many, 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 people are in there already having their, champagne and
morning
their
cocktail.
Breakfast. Yeah. Oh, it's a party. It's a very neat party, a classy party.
Now, this year they did something a little bit different. Because there are so many vendors and booths, they sort of split them into a north and a south pavilion. And in the past, most of the stuff has been concentrated down on the north end of the field. There you can see another shot from Little Buck with our balloon crew.
At some angles, you can almost swear that they're going to bump into each other.
That probably has happened.
But they avoid each other somehow. And Tom was telling us last year, I believe, that they do on occasion tap each other and still manage to steer away.
Still some more great shots from Little Buck. And there is a shot of Little Buck, one of the two piggy bank balloons from Norwest Bank here in Albuquerque. And one of the crowd favorites when it comes to the special shapes. You know, you're in store for a lot over the next 9 days. As we've said before, 850 hot air and gas balloons. And the theme this year is to change your altitude. That's what they're calling this year's Fiesta.
Change your altitude, huh?
Uh-huh.
As opposed to change your attitude.
They'll represent 41 states, 16 countries, and the pilots will be involved in 9 days of flying. We have 5 morning mass ascensions, 4 special shapes events, 3 evening balloon glows, 2 prize grab days, and a partridge in a pear tree. It almost sounds like the 12 days of Christmas.
And we're going to be seeing a lot of pins. Pins, pins, more pins, as Marjorie Shapiro Stein, a poet here at Albuquerque, says, or a writer, says, annual syndrome attributed to a crazed influx of fanatics who scope the field, rove the parties, sail the air, and search the tents, all for pins and pins and more pins.
And we'll be back with more of our live coverage from Balloon Fiesta Park in just a moment.
You're watching Action 7 News live coverage of the 1998 Balloon Fiesta Mass Ascensions. Once again, your hosts, Nelson Martinez, Diane Anderson, and Dick Nippin.
Good morning again. And there's one of the other Channel 7 banner balloons going up this morning.
It's the largest display of specially shaped balloons in the world, the 27th annual KOAT Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta.
Speaking of special shapes, Little Buck is one of the special shapes, and Wayne Bond is a pilot who's been flying in this balloon fiesta for years, and flying special shaped balloons requires a little bit more effort, and we're going to try to go up there and talk to him live. Wayne, can you hear us?
And just like every year, we have to get a bug or two out.
Well, it's kind of hard. You know, I'm amazed at the technology. It's kind of hard to go up and talk to somebody.
There
and
he is.
Hi, Wayne.
Right over the top of you. Right?
Yeah.
If you'll look straight up, you'll see us.
I see you.
We're having a beautiful morning.
Don't drop anything.
The box is working perfectly. It looks like the launch is going good. And the crowd is great.
So, is this the most exciting kind of morning for, I'm sure it can be a little more scary on some of the other mornings with the wind, but this has got to be the best kind of a morning for a balloon pilot.
Hey, Wayne.
He's like, leave me alone, I'm trying to fly my balloon.
Yeah, he is indeed about, I would say, a little over 600 feet above us. Hey, Wayne, can you hear us still?
And right below him is the turtle balloon that we were talking about. This is a new shape for us to see. There's Wayne.
Yeah. We've lost a little bit, probably because he's right overhead, you see. We've got a camera pointed straight up, and we see his little belly.
Little buck.
Little buck's belly, that is.
Seeing his shoestrings hanging down there. And right below him is the turtle that we were talking about earlier.
And a quiz, little kids at home, what is little buck for? For you to save money. No, that's so important. It's so important. Save some money.
There's the turtle. And as I mentioned earlier, when he was on the ground, when you gave him a puff of hot air, his little head popped up and back down. It's kind of scary for some of the younger kids, especially if you take them out to the Special Shapes Rodeo, which is later this week. The dragon and some of those others, when they're inflating them, they move around. They look like they're about to reach down and bite the top off of another balloon, and then they lift back up.
This is collaborative effort, if you will, of painting the sky in New Mexico, the land of enchantment. Good to have all of you. I know a lot of folks have their ringside seats up by the RV camps here all around the field here, and they tune us in. I saw all those portable antennas spring up out of the RVs, and we're happy to have you in Albuquerque.
And then they can climb out and sit on top of the RV and watch the balloons from
there. Oh, they bring out their chairs, their caviar, if you will, a little champagne. Eh? No, it's good to have. It's neat to meet all these people from all over. I even saw somebody from, of course, New York. They're down here.
Of course.
The
Fiesta has 78 acres with 2,200 sites for the campers and the RVers, and they get a choice of having either a standard, a premium, or a VIP parking. I won't ask which one you got. And all those spaces require a three-night minimum reservation, but of course people come, many of them, and stay for the entire 9 days.
They are making money in this thing. This is a big business, these RV things.
Well, there's big business all around the
No kidding.
Fiesta.
You know, each one of these RVers pays approximately $50 a night to stay, and that's sometimes, I believe that's dry. I don't even know what the dry meaning. They don't have hookups. Some of them do have hookups. I'm not sure what that costs.
You know, and 60 to 70 of those camp spaces are people just like yourself who live in Albuquerque and want to take their own RV down so they don't have to fight the traffic, and they can sit out there and have like a little mini vacation without ever leaving town.
My wife and I were sitting there last night just so comfortable knowing I didn't have to get up at 4 like you did. We got
rub
up at
it
6.
In. Actually, it was 3:45. Thank you.
That's brutal on the body.
One of the things that people do every year, of course, out of the Balloon Fiesta is collect all the different collectibles, and there's so many different ones. One of them is the pen. And this year they have 8 different official KOAT Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta pins, and they will represent different things such as, well, they have a pin for the official event pin, special shapes, the American Challenge pin, the Chase Crew pin, the Dawn Patrol pin, the Flight of Nations pin, the Balloon Glow pin, and the Anniversary pin. and the ballpoint pin, yeah,
the ballpoint
pin. All right, let's go to another break, and we'll be back to bring you these beautiful live pictures from Balloon Fiesta Park in just a moment. Stay with us.
You're watching Action 7 News live coverage of the 1998 Balloon Fiesta Mass Ascensions. Once again, your hosts, Nelson Martinez, Diane Anderson, and Dick Nippin.
That's us. That's us, Diane. They just talked about
us
on television.
Huh?
You know what? this balloon stuff, this actual event, well, you know, that led up to this event, uh-huh. 200 years old at least. At least they started back in, the 1780 something, I believe.
Oh, ballooning.
The first ballooning experience. And look what it's turned into, huh? A sea of people that come to make it happen. Without the interest of, pardon me, the spectators here, it wouldn't be such a beautiful event.
Well, actually, the people who make it such a terrific event, too, are those volunteers that work year-round. They have one of the most active volunteer organizations in order to put this on. Everything from planning the different events to getting all the information out to all the pilots to the parking. I'm always amazed at the Kiwanis and the other organization. I'm not sure which one the other one is that are out there early in the morning making sure that we get parked in the right place.
Mm-hmm. They're incredible because, you know, it takes love of this sport, if you call it that. Is it a sport, I suppose? But anyway, this event, it takes a lot of love for it, and I was reading in the paper yesterday, in the journal, some about this. A couple that's been doing it for 17 years now, their daughter's doing it, mm-hmm. and bringing the baby as well, like they brought her. It was great. I think it was Sanchez family or something. I can't remember, but it's that way. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of volunteers make this happen.
Let's go over to Dick Nipping now, and he has some guests who are joining him from out in the middle of the Balloon Fiesta field. Dick?
I'm sorry, I didn't get a pronouncer. That's all right. I'm all right. Okay. All right, now I am all right. I think I'm all right. It's Dick Nipping. Over here, I've got two visitors who've never seen anything like this. They're both from Mexico. They're both medical students at the University of New Mexico, Dulce Camarena and Diana Jimenez. Ladies, what do you think of this?
It's amazing. We are surprised.
I'm so happy to be here. I've never seen something like that.
What's your impression being out there? You're out there in the middle of this as it was all being launched. What did you think about that?
I don't know how to say it. It's beautiful. I don't have words for this.
It's beautiful. You have to come and see by your own eyes.
Have you ever seen anything like this in Mexico? Is ballooning popular at all in Mexico? Were you aware of it before?
No, really no. We have... we don't have the space and for this, and I haven't seen anything like this.
Yeah, me too, I never seen.
Nothing at all like this before. How did you hear about this?
In the UNM, everybody told us to come here.
Said you have to get out here and experience this. Huh?
Yes.
Okay. We got here at 4 o'clock in the morning. It's cold, but it's perfect.
Cold. Well, if you guys are training to be doctors, you got to get up at all kinds of times of day and night, right? And this will be a lot more fun than some of that maybe someday. All right, thank you both for being with us. Two young ladies from Mexico.
¿Hablan español?
Sí.
Pues saludos en español para su gente. Saludos a todos de México.
Come on out here at the Balloon Fiesta for everybody from everywhere. All right, now back to you guys.
And that's the truth. Germany, Belgium, Denmark, you name it, they're here. Japan, Czechoslovakia.
You know, one of the things that we might want to remind everyone of is, along with all the hot air balloons every year, they have a gas balloon event as well. And this afternoon is actually the kickoff of the 4th America's Challenge gas balloon race. It'll take off probably, I don't know, about 5:30 this afternoon, 4:30,
right.
Something like that.
5:30 is what it's scheduled for.
And it will feature four teams from four different countries. And of course, what they try to do is see who can go the longest distance. And they get everywhere from somewhere, you know, around New Mexico to way off in Kansas.
No
and
kidding.
A lot of different places. Some of them have traveled as...
Steve Fawcett, once again, wants to tackle it again, tries.
We hear word that he's around here somewhere, too. Maybe we'll get to talk
Maybe
to him.
Maybe get to talk to him, see what his plans are. But he does have intentions, I read, that he's going to give it another whirl.
We might do it.
Good
well,
luck.
Let's go outside the Balloon Fiesta Park right now and find out what's going on with the people who are... you know, maybe starting to land or who are out there viewing it from a long distance.
From the cheap seats. The people that are viewing it from the cheap seats. Let's see.
Or the smart seats, depending. Let's go out and check out with Renee Ruelas.
Well, Diane, we're out here along Alameda and I-25. Now, some people got the idea to pull over here. We've got about 100, maybe even 200 people that are along I-25 in Alameda watching the balloon fiesta. We have got a great view of all the balloons. You can see them. Some of them are even heading our way. People have loaded up with coffee and jackets. We even have a dog out here that came well prepared with his sweater. He's staying nice and warm watching the balloons go up as well. Now, people had this idea before they even got out here. They brought blankets and chairs. So they knew about this spot and they knew what was going on well ahead of time and made their way out here. And we met someone out here named Gail Patrick. She is from El Paso and she knew this is where she was going to come. Gail, you said you started to come out here at 6 a.m.?
Yeah, we've been out here since about 5 to 6 this morning. The traffic was just unbearable out there. They had the roads blocked off for one way, so we thought, we've got the best seat in the house up here. And we had some family that had come in from California that is staying in a motorhome down on the park. And we weren't sure they were going to even make it up here because it was so crowded.
So you think they might even still be in traffic?
Well, no, they're the ones with the little dog.
Okay, well, we've got a great view up here. All the balloons, some of them actually heading over us. And we'll keep you up to date on what comes on over here. If any of them even land in the parking lot while we're here, we'll let you know. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Renee.
I see something I haven't seen before, and that is a tractor with a little shuttle kind of hayride looking thing behind it. But what you're seeing right now is a scene from Little Buck and our balloon cam.
Wayne, are you listening? Hello, Wayne.
I think he's flying is what he's doing. But that's kind of what it looks like if you're up in the air, flying around with all the other balloons on a Mass Ascension Day. And if you're ever going to go up in a balloon, I'd say Mass Ascension Day is the day to do it, because everywhere you look, up, down, to the side, there's a balloon.
And you know, it's the same thing every year, but it's still electrical. For me, anyway, I speak for myself. I get a little rush when I see all these people out here. What are they doing here at 5 in the morning? And now it's 7-something. What is it, 8 o'clock already? You mean we've been here an hour already? My, time flies when you're having fun. And we were just talking about how we were just here last year. It seems like it was 6 months ago.
Mm-hmm. Goes by pretty quickly. I'm sure it does for the people who are working on it throughout the year. And Tom Rutherford is one of those who helps bring us the Balloon Fiesta each year. And he's out now being our special correspondent on the field, Tom.
We've been showing you the inside of balloon baskets and watching as balloons lift off, and you may have noticed that when you're in the basket, you can't see above the balloon, and so you need somebody outside the perimeter of the balloon to help you when you launch to let you know there's no traffic overhead. That's what the zebras do. This is Tony Martoni, and Tony, you're going to launch about 25 balloons this morning, you said.
Yes, I will.
And are you about to start the second wave?
Yes, we are. I'm getting ready to leave the mic and go tell my balloons to go hot right now so we can get them out of here.
Are there 35 launch directors?
There's about 35, 40 of us.
That's what I figured. Yeah. So you're going to be standing outside the balloon. Who are you talking to on that headset?
To the people up. We all have controllers down in the people's a tower down the end of the field, and they're telling us when it's clear to launch.
So it's all coordinated from a tower, and you let the pilots know when to go. And how do you do that?
Basically, we sit around and blow the old whistle and give them a thumbs up and get them out of here safely and coordinated.
Tony's on his way to give the thumbs up to the second wave of balloons here at the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta.
Hundreds of balloons in the air already, and it's just starting the second wave.
In a word, perfect. Perfect.
More than 1 million spectators are expected out here to view these balloons over the 9 days of this year's Balloon Fiesta. You know, it takes a 23-member volunteer board just to keep all the committees that put this all together throughout the year. Here are some of the committees that they organize each year. Parking, volunteers, chase crews, concessions, event development, cash management, field operations, real estate, sponsorship, operations, violations and appeals, balloon mail, hospitality, government relations, the Explorium, gas ballooning and finance. And there are committees, people who serve on each of those committees that work 12 months out of the year to make sure that this 9-day event goes off without too many hitches each year.
There are very few, if any, as you know.
Well, let's go to a break and we'll be back with more of our live coverage from Balloon Fiesta Park in just a moment. Good morning, and thanks again for joining us out at Balloon Fiesta Park for live coverage of this year's Mass Ascension, the first of 9 days of balloon fun. Let's go out on the field where Joe Diaz is. Joe?
We talked about the balloons going up in waves, and indeed, 870 balloons will go up this morning, and going up in three waves. Now, the first one is history. The first wave is up in the air. We're getting ready to start on the second wave right now. In fact, the balloon that I'm next to over here, we'll be talking to the pilot in just a little bit. The launch director came by and he said, hey, go ahead and cold inflate, get hot, and then you get to get out of here. So the second wave is really going. We've talked about the Albuquerque box before, and what we have this morning is that the balloons get up, they go to the south, and you really only have to get up about 800 feet in the air before you catch that north wind, and it'll take you back over the field. And a lot of the balloons that you see up in the air right now are people taking advantage of that Albuquerque box. They launched, they went to the south, and now they're working back over the field as the second wave is getting ready to go up. The thing I like about this is that it's not only a great recreational sport, but it's a spectator sport. And like football, if you're watching football, you're out in the bleachers and you never get on the field. Here, you get out on the field and you walk around all the balloons and you hear the burners going off and the balloon baskets launching all around you. And we have all kinds of people. You know, they say you got to dress in layers, and I guess that includes the dog, too. What's the name of your puppy here?
Scuffy.
Scuffy the puppy, huh? And
yes.
Where are you from?
Los Angeles.
Los Angeles. How many fiestas have you gone to?
First one ever.
So what do you think about it?
I love it. It's great.
What brought you out here? I mean, I know you heard it was a great thing to do, but I mean...
Well, my grandparents used to live in Albuquerque, uh-huh. And we had heard about it, and we've seen pictures, and we've just... always wanted to come to it, and we just happened to be here at this time.
Isn't it fantastic just to walk around and see all the action around you?
Unbelievable.
I remember the first time I saw one balloon going up, it was amazing, but to have 800 going up. Huh. Let's go ahead and talk to some of the folks over here. The name is Scuffy or...
Scuffy.
Scuffy the dog. Okay, where are you guys from?
I'm from Las Vegas.
Las Vegas? You getting right. Some good pictures?
I'm getting some great pictures. I'm on my third roll. My daughter and her fiance came in to just see the balloons, it's incredible.
Oh, great. Let's go talk to them. Where are you guys from?
We're from Dallas.
Have you been to very many balloon fiestas before?
We have never been here.
What's your name?
Alan Jackson.
Alan Jackson?
Danielle DeQuani. You're
going to
sing a couple songs for us?
Don't rock that jukebox.
So what do you think about this? Have you seen anything like it?
Never in my entire life. This is the most incredible, beautiful day, and it looks like something off out of Christmas, like, you know, like balls on a Christmas tree just hanging. It's just, it's beautiful weather. We've had 56 days of over 100 degrees in Dallas.
So. Yeah, boy, it's been terrible over there.
Welcome break coming to this, and we're cold, and it's great here.
What are some of the favorite balloons that you've seen going up?
Oh, the Mountie. There's one that's a horse. It looks like the Canadian Mountie, and then there's the Canadian Maple Leaf. There's another one that's the Turtle. That's already up there, and there goes the one that's from what is that? The little character.
Little smiley face
smiley
over
face
there.
Guy.
Yeah. So it's the International Balloon Fiesta. People come from all over the country, all over the world to participate over here. Behind me, we have a pilot getting in his cold inflation process. The launch director was here. He said that this one will be going up in just a little bit, so we'll try to cut back in and show you when he gets up and out of here from the field. It's really kind of quite a neat sight. You hear the burners going and the applause going off from the spectators as they take to the sky. So that's the story. The second wave on the field is already starting to take off, and we'll keep you up to date. Back to you guys.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Joe. You know, I saw a glimpse of the Michelin Man. That's another new one this year, I believe. He's a larger than life 150-foot tall hot air balloon that celebrates the tire company's 100th anniversary with a flying visit here. And I see Tony the Tiger is making his face known. And then there's that little purple people eater thing that we see every year, and never really sure what that is. And then little Buck's sister, Miss Penny, is inflating, cold inflating back behind us.
Here's right.
Tony the Tiger.
Hey, I grew up with that guy. And in fact, the tiger people, they sent me a very nicely framed Tony the Tiger, three of them or something, and then my name embedded in there.
Ah.
It was cool. Maybe they can do one for
you. You're
going
to have to eat a lot of Frosted Flakes, huh? Well, let's go on over and talk to Dick Niffing and his special guest. Dick?
Actually, I was hoping Nelson could do that great.
Oh, don't encourage him. He gets kind of giddy on these mornings.
I'm over here with Carolyn Pollack, who is a TV star in her own right. On QVC. Carolyn, what are you doing out here?
Well, actually, we produce most of QVC Southwestern Jewelry right here in Albuquerque. Our company's name is Relios, and my husband and I have about 150 employees right here in Albuquerque. So we're featuring our product just south of the stage.
There are vendors and there are vendors out here, and this is a really classy operation. Carolyn, tell us, how did you get into this? You're not from this part of the country. How did you get into Native American jewelry and become an expert at it?
Well, I just fell in love with this whole culture and obviously the beauty that we see behind us here. Back in about 1988 when I was visiting and begged the company I was working with at the time to move me here because I really felt I belonged here. And my husband has actually been manufacturing jewelry here for 24 years. So.
Wow.
Yeah.
And I see those earrings that you have on today.
Those are featured.
Be part of them,
yeah.
Right?
Yes.
You have been on QVC quite often though, haven't you?
Several times. A couple times a month, yeah, for the last 3 years. And it's really helped the company grow. It's helped the customers have a greater appreciation for this culture that really inspires the jewelry we present on the air.
How big a deal is this for vendors like you, the Balloon Fiesta?
Oh, it's fabulous. It's really neat to meet our customers person to person, and you know, everybody's in a great mood here too, so it's just a wonderful celebration.
And in a business sense, is it good for you?
Absolutely, yes.
Or you wouldn't be here, huh?
Yeah.
Dumb question.
I'd be in bed. No, I'd be here, but I'd be out there.
All right, Carolyn, thanks for being with us. Carolyn
Pollack.
Thanks
for having me.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
All right, back to you, Nelson and Diane.
A kaleidoscope there. Look at that.
Mm-hmm. There's the DiGiorno rising pizza, rising balloon. Back on the other side, the Michelin man you can see in the distance. There's Tony the Tiger. It's something you might want to check out after the balloons go up and you start looking around at the vendors and the different booths. But you can also go down to the south end of the vending area where there's a circular blue tent and they have the balloon museum display there and kind of take a look at what is going to be in that museum and how it's going to look and something to look forward to as the Balloon Fiesta continues to grow throughout the years. Let's go to a break now and we'll be back with more of our live coverage of the 1998 Balloon Fiesta in just a moment.
Action 7 News Balloon Fiesta coverage.
There
and
goes
good
another
morning
photograph.
Again.
Another photograph. And another photograph.
See the Canadian Mountie? He has already gone to the south, came back to the north, and is headed south again. So you know the box is working really well.
There he is. Hey, we got the front shot this time. Making progress. The
and
Canadian
we talked about the Michelin Man, mountain. But I also saw a Uniroyal tire balloon out there, too.
Can you imagine people who live in a cave and are just passing by Albuquerque and seeing this spectacle?
I'm sure that is fun for people who are traveling through and don't realize that this is the time of year for Balloon Fiesta. A welcome surprise.
And
Chili Ristra is out there, cold inflating. That's another local balloon, and last year was its debut. And
last year,
making a return this year.
Last year, Governor Johnson had his little motto saying, Están todos en su casa, telling everyone that you are home when you come to Albuquerque, this Balloon Fiesta. Están todos en su casa.
You know, back at the station, you've been hearing a lot over the past year about our Super Doppler 7 radar and how it brings you the latest in technology when it comes to making sure that you're safe from all the weather. But Bo Cooper has found another use for it. I guess we're going to have to change it to Super Duper Doppler 7, Bo.
Super Duper Doppler Balloon 7. I'll tell you what, normally we track rain showers and storms, but with all of the balloons suspended in the air over Albuquerque, especially the North Valley, we're picking up some radar reflections right now. All of the green that you see is that mass ascension now. At various altitudes, you'd like to see little round circles, but when they're all together like that, simply gives us a nice area. If it were a rainy day, I would say it'd be raining right there, but we've got all the balloons in the sky, so we are seeing some Doppler reflections from that. You can see I-25 here, and there's tramways that comes in. Balloon Fiesta Park right in this area. Looks like most of the mass ascension is drifting a little bit to the west over the Rio Grande. Just an interesting application for Super Doppler 7. Back to you guys live at Balloon Fiesta Park.
That just shows that it takes the expertise of our weathermen to interpret what Super Doppler 7 is seeing.
Isn't that wild? And you know, it also shows up, of course, in big time. It shows up in the FAA, that's the Federal Aviation Administration, scopes.
Mm-hmm.
And boy, they have issued weeks ago a a stay away warning to all general aviation pilots and pilots, commercial pilots as well. This is an area that, of course, is all reserved for balloonists these next 2 weeks. Tom Rutherford has been about and about with more folks. Hi, Tom.
Good morning. I'm with some old friends and some new friends. I was walking by and Wayne stopped me and said, "You look familiar." And I said, "I'm Tom Rutherford." He said, "Well, I'm Wayne Fieseth, and we went to Highland High School together back in the early 1960s, and Wayne was on the swimming team. And you were at Rio Grande?
Rio Grande High School.
What was your maiden name?
Class of 64, Linda Thompson.
And now you haven't ever seen the Balloon Fiesta before, have you?
We haven't been out here before, no.
Where are you living now?
We're in Moore, Oklahoma, just south of Oklahoma City.
And for how long?
We've been over there 10 years.
But you've been out of Albuquerque longer than that, haven't you?
Yeah, we've been working all over the state of New Mexico. I was with the Natural Resources Conservation Service.
Wayne's folks still live over on Jefferson, and they're watching at home, and they're seeing the Balloon Fiesta for the first time. And I think it's one of the things that happens to us from Albuquerque. We end up coming back and enjoying things. Now, you don't have a Lobo jacket on.
No, this is an Oklahoma OU jacket, and we're going go Sooners, beat the Buffaloes today.
All right. We'll get to watch that later this afternoon. I'm here with some old friends making new friends at the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta.
There's the chilly ristra as it's starting to cold inflate, about to take off. Let's go on out to off the field where Dan Monahan is checking out things there. Dan?
Diane, we're at the Burger King, believe it or not, at Alameda and I-25. And we came in here because it seems everybody else was coming in here. I don't know if we get a shout out the front here right now, but this is what they're calling their quiet time this morning. The crowd has died down quite a bit. There's only a line backed up halfway through the waiting room here. Now, we're going to ask what the deal is here with the Balloon Fiesta in the business as soon as we can get her off this.
Okay, what drink would you like?
Can I take their order for them? Is
you want the headset?
Everything's free today.
Okay, that's
she's busy at the moment. Anyway, one of the great things here is that the drive-up window, the workers here fight for the drive-up window duty because the view out there is the balloon field. Because he came over. You came over here just because you wanted to look out the window, didn't you? Don't lie to me. Yeah. You didn't. He comes in here and wants to be on TV and this. And are you done taking orders now? They can wait. They don't know. Now, what's your name?
My name's Pat.
And you are the owner of all Burger King?
Absolutely. Okay. No, I'm the restaurant manager of this location.
Busier than usual today?
Yes. We plan for this starting tomorrow for next year.
Starting tomorrow? You didn't start yesterday for next year.
Actually, we'll start right after this one for next year.
It's all hot food. You guys don't really have a breakfast burrito, but what's a hot item?
The Cinni Minis and the French toast sticks. Sausage croissants.
Are people driving in here just out of frustration off the highway and come through your drive-thru faster than trying to get to the park?
A lot of them, yeah. And they use our parking lot and our playroom.
You do have quite a crowd out there. Yeah. And you notice it out in the front, the most popular seats seem to be on the west side.
We never get to sit there.
Great. Well, again, we'll give you one more look out their window here, the drive-up window. She goes back to work. Thanks, Pat, for putting up with us.
Well, thank you.
And we'll toss it back to you guys in the field where you almost have as good a view as this drive-up window does.
One of the perks at working at that Burger King, huh? Well, I just saw the rubber ducky go up. What a cute balloon. Has little water underneath with fish and I can't tell, maybe even a whale underneath. Tadpole, maybe. And the that's another of the new special shapes.
There's the mountain of the second wave, is it? Or is it no, this is the end of the second wave, I
think
believe.
There's the rubber ducky.
And they're starting to get it.
Rubber ducky is owned by Brian and Susan Owen of Plano, Texas, and they're bringing it here for the first time. Let's go over to Dick Niffy now, who has an old buddy of mine with him. Good morning.
Well, we're over here singing the rubber ducky song.
Oh, goody.
I'm with Mary Ann Reardon, former television news anchor, former television news producer, and now maybe has one of the toughest jobs of all. She is the spokesperson for the State Highway Department, that agency we all love to, well, not exactly love.
Oh, come on, Dick. Now, I think the Highway Department has made great strides in community and public service in the last few years.
Yes, since you've been there communicating. Now, you have a, she has a chicken, duck, turkey. What is this bird here?
This is the Interstate Ernie. He is the New Mexico State Highway and Transportation Department mascot. Huh. And he does have a personality crisis going on here. People have been calling him, hey, Ducky, hey, Turkey Boy. So
you can make a balloon out of him?
He's a roadrunner. Someday, maybe, you know, when we have private funding, I think we'd have to do that with
But him. Seriously, Mary Ann, tell us about highway projects that are underway right now that could affect people at the Balloon Fiesta. What to watch out for, what's getting better, and what's not getting better.
Well, it's a pretty tall order, Dick, but I'll tell you the good news for anybody who commutes on I-40 at Tramway is today or sometime this weekend, the majority of the traffic control will be removed from there. All the ramps will open, all the restricted lanes will be open. So that's been going on for about 9 or 10 months. It's almost done. They'll just use the cosmetics now, and there'll be periodic lane closures for striping. Then on the Wyoming project will wrap up before the month is out, and Highway 44 is done from 528 to San Ysidro, so that's great for anybody wanting to head to Farmington. And for people in Santa Fe, there's a little bad news there. There's on Cerrillos Road from Siler to St. Michael's, for the next 3 weeks, they'll be doing road construction there, paving and milling, so seek an alternate route, but that's tough in Santa Fe.
Probably a lot of these people out here will be going up to Santa Fe.
That's right.
You know, the one nightmare that we all dread here in Albuquerque and we're all not looking forward to, but which is coming, is the reconstruction of the Big Eye. Where's that, Marianne?
Well, it's a 16-month design phase. They're about 2 months into it, and only 24 months is the ideal optimum of the construction. So we won't have to worry about it in Balloon Fiesta 1999, but Balloon Fiesta 2000 will definitely be in the middle of it. And I think that, you know, the highway department and the contractor, we're all working together to provide a lot of public information. We recommend, like, Interstate Ernie has his SOV sticker on. Single
that is SOV.
SOV as in Victor. And that's for single occupancy vehicles. Try to avoid them. If you can carpool, it'll help us all. Share a ride.
Or if you have a hot air balloon, just fly right over it.
Hot air balloon or right. Sky 7.
Thanks, Marianne. Marianne Reardon from the Highway Department and Interstate Ernie, our favorite roadrunner. Diane Nelson.
Marianne should have a camera on her all the time. She's so nice when she's on camera.
She's always nice. No, get in, Marianne.
We did work with Marianne for a long time. She was our producer.
One of my favorite producers.
Yeah,
I've seen a lot of special shapes go up in the last little bit, including Miss Daisy and the Chili Ristra and Beloved Arrow, which is the mommy dog and the little dog there. You've seen some shots from Sky 7. That is the ViewSonic.
ViewSonic, yep.
That's a giant computer screen with parrots perched on it.
Making its first appearance at this year's Fiesta. Computer monitor.
There's the Sky 7 shot for you, and you can hear the rotors in the background. And we'll be back with more of our live coverage in just a moment, so don't go away.
You're watching Action 7 News live coverage of the 1998 Balloon Fiesta Mass Ascensions. Once again, your hosts, Nelson Martinez, Diane Anderson, and Dick Nippin.
Good morning again. Also out there is Joe Diaz. He's out on the field and among the balloons. Are there still some going up out there, Joe?
Yeah, exactly right. We're midway through the second wave, and when you're on the field, the neat thing is to see them cold deflate, and then of course they put the propane burners on, and then the balloon goes up in the air. Then it's a waiting game, and you wait for the whistles to come up, and right now we're getting the A-OK from the launch director to go up. So this is Mike Kelly. Mike, I guess you're ready to go?
Right. We're taking off now, I'm afraid. Clear?
Okay, there's the thumbs up. How's it going this morning?
Super, beautiful day. Been one of the best days I've ever seen flying out here.
I love that, don't you? The balloon takes off. There you have Mike Kelly. He came all the way from San Diego, California. And then when they lift up into the air, they get the applause from the crowd below.
And that's just midway through the second wave here at the International Balloon Fiesta. Mike will be drifting in a southerly direction. He'll get about 800 feet up in the air, and then the upper level winds will take him to the north because the Albuquerque box is working really well today. So that's just some of the sights and some of the sounds down here on the field. They'll pick this tarp off, and then the third wave will start to line up from this site, and they'll be taken off shortly as well. Back to you guys, Diana Nelson.
Thank you, Joe. You know what Joe just saw right out there on the field is what you get to see if you come out. You don't get held back away from the balloons. You can walk right up to the people as they take off.
That's kind of neat.
We have a very important guest over here. His name is Mike Chandler. He's the vice president of Trigas, and Trigas is deeply involved in the America's Challenge gas balloon race, which we hope will launch this afternoon, but Mike was just telling me maybe not. Mike, what do you know?
Well, I know that Mark Sullivan and the committee is meeting right now to decide
whether or not with the weather conditions that are coming up, whether or not the race is going to take place tonight or not.
Trigas, of course, provides the helium for those balloons. How much helium does it take, and how expensive is it for that?
Well, per balloon, there's approximately 35,000 feet of gas at a cost to a pilot on a given market of about $5,000 to $7,000 per fill.
Wow, so that's a 2 or 3 day flight, and it costs that much money just for the gas.
Yeah, that's right. That's why it's not for everybody.
As opposed to about $25 for propane for a 2 or 3 hour flight in a hot air balloon.
That's right.
You were telling me something fascinating about helium. Now, I had no idea where helium comes from, and I bet you our viewers don't know either. Where do you get helium?
Well, actually, it's a process of extracting it out of the ground in gas deposits that are under the ground. It's like you said earlier, it's like mining for gas.
And you have to get it, and then none of that's done here in New Mexico, though, right?
No, sir. There was a deposit up in around the Shiprock area that was open for a period of time, but most of it's concentrated in Kansas, and it's extracted out of the ground, purified, brought to a very high purity, and then sold in either a cryogenic liquid or a gaseous state.
All right, thanks, Mike. Mike Chandler from Trigas, sponsor of the America's Cup, not America's Cup, America's Challenge gas balloon race. We hope that gets off the ground this afternoon.
Thank you.
All right, back to Nelson and Diane.
Thank you. That's a nice information to know. Boy, they make some money. $2,000 on the average it costs to fill up one of those balloons.
The long distance ones.
Also going on right around the corner here from Balloon Fiesta Park, in case you're on your RV or whatever, or at home, don't forget, it's the 10th annual, I believe, Rio Grande Arts and Crafts, just up the road in that huge tent. And if you're looking for Christmas shopping already, mind you, there are just tons of creations by New Mexico artists.
You might even pick up a chili ristra like that one that's flying in the air.
Oh, that's good. I was impressed. I was there last year. In fact, I'm going to be there this morning at 11 o'clock and I'll sing a few tunes to the folks out there with my mariachi track.
Well, Joe Diaz is out on the field. Joe, what are you doing?
I'm here talking to some of the spectators and ran across the chief executive officer of the Albuquerque Convention and Visitors Bureau, Keith Arnold. And Keith, I know you're new to the job. You came on board in January, and I guess this is your first Balloon Fiesta under your belt. How's it going?
Well, it's incredible, and it's lived up to more than all the expectations. The numbers of people are great. We're really happy they're in town, but the balloons are beautiful, and the organization is just incredible.
So are you a spectator, or are you at an official capacity right now?
Well, I think I'm an official spectator this morning. We have a hospitality tent. We run for all the group tours that are coming into town. We work with the out-of-town media, but we're really here, my wife and I, to take it all in, and it's a lot to take in.
So is this your first fiesta that you've witnessed or what?
Well, I actually saw it in 1981, and it was probably about a quarter the size of what it is now. So for all practical purposes, you could say this is my first, and it's certainly come a long way in 27 years.
Now, your wife, Linda, this is the first time you've witnessed something like this. Is it about what you'd expect or what?
Oh, it's much more. I am so impressed with the teamwork and the organization and the whole organization is amazing.
Isn't it fun just to go walk around the balloons and see them all taken off around you and hearing the propane and all that?
Oh, I don't know which way to look between all the bright colors and the propane going off. It's very exciting.
Now, Keith, we talk about this being such an economic impact to Albuquerque and how it really puts us on the map. You know, we see it year after year after year. We kind of take it for granted, but this is really a signature for the town, isn't it?
Well, it is a signature for the town, and the number of phone calls over the past 2 weeks in our information centers and the license plates you see around town, it continues to be a growth event. It's something that the world pays attention to, and there's very good reason it's the world's most photographed event, too, when you come out and stand in the middle of it.
And we get a good economic boost from it?
We do. We have about 1.5 million people who come to the event, and it's worth tens of millions of dollars to our community, ranging from Old Town to the bus tour companies.
Well, fantastic. Keith Arnold, Chief Executive Officer of the Albuquerque Convention and Visitors Bureau, working as an official spectator this morning. Back to you, Dick.
That's the best job to have, an official spectator. Now, on a morning like this, it is so beautiful, we don't expect there to be any problems, but sometimes there are, and we do understand there is a balloon down in the North Valley. Don't think anyone's hurt, but let's get the latest now from Mike Sims and Sky 7.
Diana Nelson, you're seeing the pictures now. We are in between 2nd and Edith, south of Paseo del Norte, where a balloon has been tied up in power lines. You can see the, I guess it's the power company with their cherry picker trying to untangle the balloon that I guess flew a little bit too low and landed into the lines. We understand no one is injured, but again, the envelope is completely folded over the top line. Of course, that means that they probably have to shut off power to the whole entire neighborhood until they get this untangled, power restored to the neighborhood. Again, we are in between 2nd and Edith Street in Los Ranchos, south of Paseo del Norte. Bernalillo County Sheriff's deputies and fire and rescue are on scene, but the good news is, again, that no one is injured. Pretty unusual, like you said, because the winds are fairly calm. The balloons are staying up much longer than they did last year. So we don't expect to see anything like this, but again, perhaps pilots are unfamiliar with the area. You know, accidents happen, but no one's injured in this scene. Back to you.
All right, thank you, Mike.
Thanks,
and
Mike.
You're looking at Arabelle,
yeah,
the Creamland cow balloon, and one of the favorites of the Fiesta each year, the special shapes, and always one of the last to go up because it is so big and there are so many different little parts to it that it takes a while to get it inflated and get it up and going. Always one of her legs is a little limp until they get her up and...
Got to make sure that udder looks like it's healthy, you know.
That's true.
Can feed this entire country from that udder.
But this morning has been spectacular, especially in light of the last weekend of last year's Balloon Fiesta. It was not a good weekend for flying and it was a little bit of a disappointment for a lot of people. So it's made a big change this year, and everything is off
beautiful.
To a really good start.
Mm. And it's, you know, I noticed this morning, and we were talking about it, it is not as cold as it's been.
Mm-mm.
It's just been perfect, the big
so come on
P word, perfect.
Well, let's go to a break, and we'll be back with more of our live coverage from Balloon Fiesta Park in just a moment.
People, tens of thousands. I would guess that's a conservative estimate. Tens of thousands of people? Tens of thousands, at least.
The balloons are up and gone from the field, and the people are covering the field now. And out there among all those people somewhere is Tom Rutherford.
It's Kodak Day at the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta, and I'm here with film maven Master Sergeant Patty Blaine. And she's the film lady, at least for this little sector of the balloon field. How many rolls of film are you going to sell today, do you think?
Oh, about 200.
And you're with the Air Force, and you use this as a fundraiser for the squadron, is that right?
Yes, we do.
And how many kinds of, I mean, you have all Kodak film, but like different speeds and things?
Oh, we've got everything you can possibly put in a camera.
And do people just forget to bring film, or they use more than they thought they would?
Oh, a little of both, but mostly they use more than they thought.
And so you're here to help them out?
Yes, I am.
Well, like a jillion pictures get taken during the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta. As you said earlier, it's the most photographed event in the world, and taking pictures is sure part of the fun here, but eating things at the Balloon Fiesta is fun too, and Dick Niffing as a guest who knows all about that.
Boy, does he ever. Thank you, Tom. This is Mike King, and he is the tour manager for one of my favorite companies, Johnsonville Brats. Is there a Charlie Murphy?
No, they're all on commercials, there is.
I love that. He's out there, Charlie Murphy's cooking Johnsonville Brats. You know, this is your first year at the Fiesta, isn't it, Mike?
My personal first year, but Johnsonville's been here for the last 3 years.
One of the things that you notice about people who are here the first time is that they're walking around looking up like this, and you could probably stuff a brat in there, couldn't you?
I think most of them are walking by with a brat stuffed in their mouth doing that.
You have a huge grill here making all these brats. Tell me about that.
Our grill was built back in 1995, celebrating our 50th anniversary. It is 65 feet long and 6 feet in diameter. We could cook 750 brats at one time, 2,500 in 1 hour.
Brats are not just for breakfast anymore, are they?
No, they're not. They're for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Well, you know what? I'll take a little payola here, and I will take that brat. So one of the best things about the Balloon Fiesta always is the food, and there's everything out here from Johnsonville brats to, of course, the famous breakfast burritos. If you're hungry, even if you didn't like balloons, you could come out here and have a great time. But, of course, we all love the balloons. Back to Nelson and Diane.
I'm going to need to have them put a Panavision lens on these cameras after today. Actually, today hadn't been so bad. We haven't eaten anything.
I've had a breakfast burrito.
That was the tactful way for me to ask you.
Yeah.
No, actually, it's becoming nauseating now. Remember, first we went on the air, that aroma from the cinnamon rolls was nice, and just hasn't quit. I think I'm a little tired of it, actually. But anyway, it's always good.
You know, there are a lot of things to do over the next 8 days. This is just the first day, and we don't know yet whether or not the America's Challenge gas balloon race is going to go off this afternoon as planned, but there are a lot of things still left to go on during the rest of the week. The mass ascension again tomorrow, then tomorrow night at 5:30, the balloon glow, and that's followed by a fireworks show. And then, of course, there are different flying events throughout the weekday, and then there's a midweek mass ascension on Wednesday morning. That's at 7 o'clock. And then on Thursday, along with the morning events, there's also a special shape mass ascension Thursday morning, and then a special shape rodeo on Thursday evening, sponsored by Norwest Bank. And then again, another special shape mass ascension on Friday morning, and a key grab that morning, and then another special shape rodeo that afternoon. And so there's plenty of things before we get to the second weekend of the Balloon Fiesta, which will include two more mass ascensions on Saturday and Sunday mornings. So if you're wondering how to get out here, there are some basic routes to take, and let's get more now from Nanette Miranda.
National Balloon Fiesta attracts nearly a million people each year. If you dare to fight traffic, be patient. Jams are likely before major events. The routes are still the same. If you're coming in from the east side, you should take tramway. If you're coming in from the west side, you should take Alameda. Signs and traffic officers will direct you to the parking lots, which are free. And if you want a less stressful way to get to the balloon field, you can leave the hassle to a bus driver. SunTran Park and Ride runs on weekends only and leaves from each of Albuquerque's major malls, at Coronado from the northwest corner, at Windrock also from the northwest corner, and at Cottonwood from the northeast corner. Departures start at 4:30 a.m. New this year is Fiesta Express. This bus service runs every day from the Beach Water Park at Interstate 25 and Montgomery. Departures begin at 4:30 a.m. on weekends, 5:30 a.m. on weekdays, and 3:30 p.m. for afternoon events. Both Park and Ride and Fiesta Express cost $6.50 for adults and $6 for seniors. That includes admission. Yep, it's a lot cheaper this year. A child between 5 and 11 years old is free with one paying adult. Each additional kid is $6.50. And children under 4 are free. For more information and or to buy tickets, you can call ProTix at 851-5050. I know the streets around here aren't always well marked, but don't worry about getting lost. If you take tramway from the east or Alameda from the west, traffic officers and signs will make sure you get to the right spot. And besides, you'll be in a long line of cars, all making their way to the same place. Nanette Miranda, Action 7 News.
Thanks, Miranda. Very
Nanette.
Nice.
Nanette.
Miranda. I always do that. I think it's a first name, you know? It's Nanette.
Okay,
Miranda.
Thanks, Martinez.
Yeah, really. How crass. Sorry.
Look at that crowd of people now. Now, the rubber ducky, which went all the way to the south, went all the way back to the north, is coming low over the field again. Looks like it's about to land right out in the middle of all those people.
Brian and Susan Owen of Plano, Texas, piloting rubber ducky.
You know, they
ducky.
Must have a lot of events in Plano that are related to balloons, because there are several special shapes and several other balloons that are piloted by people from Plano.
And we talked about it this morning, that some of them can land even on the bed of their own trucks, like Craig Kennedy said earlier. But there it is. He landed just about where he took off, from where he took off.
And that's a thrill for the crowd, because they were, at that point, milling around trying to figure out, okay, what am I going to eat now? Where do I go? I don't want to get in the traffic just yet. So they can go over and watch the rubber ducky land. Maybe they're just going to switch crew members. A lot of times they do that. That's one of the reasons to try to be on a chase crew, which is a lot of work, is that sometimes they'll do a little bounce down, change a couple of different people, and go back up for another ride. Mm-hmm. Maybe what they're going to do.
And more interestingly as well, are the crowds here. They come in numbers. It's just phenomenal to see it live, you know, in an event that is New Mexico's own. We don't have a stadium that takes 80,000 people for football and all this and that and the other, but they're more in numbers here, I would think. There's our location, our SAT-7, as we call it, Satellite 7 truck. And
we want to say thanks to our crew. It takes a big crew out here to bring you all these different perspectives that you get when you're sitting at home watching our live coverage of the Balloon Fiesta. We have two cameras up on these cherry pickers. There's another one on the bluff. There's one in Sky 7. There's one in Miss Little Buck. And there's one couple out on the field. And all those require crew members, too, and they get up we complain about getting up early, but they get up even earlier than we do.
And our executive producer, David Sebastian, who has been at this program, rather bringing it together for months.
Don't give away his age, okay. But you're going to tell him how many years.
I mean, even yesterday he was producing the 6 o'clock news and
Double duty this time of year.
Details for this morning's launch, and it's gone off without a hitch. It's almost time to say adios, see you mañana kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
It's been quite fun this first day of the 9-day event. Very nice.
That is the tequila or Jose Cuervo bottle.
Jose Cuervo, huh?
And that's... Joe Diaz is out among the people in the crowd trying to find out what they're doing after the balloons all go up and now are headed back down. Joe?
It's really kind of a camaraderie out here because everybody gets out here. It's dark and it's cold and you all hit the coffee booths and that sort of thing. And then the balloons get up and the field is eventually cleared. And then there's that mass exodus when you leave the field. You head over into the booths and you get yourself a breakfast burrito and you hit the souvenir shops. We have some people with us, and you're from where?
San Marcos, California.
San Marcos, where is that near?
Just north of San Diego.
Have you been here before?
Never. It's wonderful.
Really?
Right.
What'd you like best of all about it?
Watching this balloon that was right here from Colorado, which is where I'm originally from.
Okay.
And I watched it all the way from the time they had it spread out.
And who are you here with today?
My brother and my nephew and all the family.
So you guys get, I notice you have a camera around your neck. You're getting some good pictures?
Oh, it's his camera. I'm carrying.
You're the grip, huh?
Yeah. Yeah. We're from Arcadia, California.
Look at this special shaped balloon just landing here behind me. In fact, I was talking to Tom Rutherford earlier, and I say, Tom, are these balloons allowed to lift off from the field and then come back in from the north and land on the field again? And he was saying, well, there's no hard, fast rule, but the general thinking is that once the balloons get up, once the final wave has gone up in the air, then it is okay to go ahead and use that box to work back down on the field and go ahead and land here. And I go, man, that's got to be easy on the chase crew. I mean, you don't even have to start your engine up and leave the field. So this is the Cuervo balloon that lifted up earlier and is working its way back down on the field. So we saw the balloons go up off the field, and Diana Nelson, we're seeing them return.
Right, that is the Aero Cuervo, 1800s Mexican masterpieces hot air balloon. It's about 12 stories tall, 100 feet high, 120 feet high. Let's go to a break, and we'll be back to wrap up our live coverage from Balloon Fiesta Park.
Back with you once again on the first day of a 9-day event.
Great day. Great day. Weather couldn't have been more perfect, could it?
Everyone is really bragging on how well the box is working, how beautiful the weather is, and it actually is warmer this year. People are starting to shed those layers that came out with
you. You still have your blanket on, though, Diane. I can see that.
I've learned over the years.
I'll tell you what, I don't think I have ever seen the box work better than it has today. It was
really
just amazing. The balloon's taking off this way, and then coming back that way.
Going north, coming back.
Yeah,
or going south, coming back north.
And many of them landing right here on the field behind us for the crowd to see. And that's good for the crowd, because a lot of times after the balloons have all gone up, they're going, okay, I can go eat something else. I can go buy some official, and there's official everything, pins and all that. But this is kind of nice because they get to continue watching the balloons.
Yeah, they do. And they're coming right back down here, Rubber Ducky and Jose Cuervo. Our friend.
I have to admit that this is my least favorite part of the Balloon Fiesta, is trying to get home.
Yeah.
Because everybody, at least when you leave really early in the morning, you can get out here. But when you try to get back home.
I'll rub it in.
I'm
just going to walk over here.
I know. I don't want to hear it.
You know what? I've never tried it. I mean, I've always wanted to have an RV out here, because that's a luxury. And just a walk over there, a five-minute walk. Tom Rutherford, we've only got a few seconds. What's your input to wrap it up on this Saturday?
Well, we're here as things are wrapping up. I'm next to the Jose Cuervo balloon and van that's deflating now. People are starting to head home. If you want to avoid the traffic, what you do is stay around and do some shopping, have brunch out here, and spend an hour or two among the folks in all the great shops. It's been a perfect day. The gas balloons will go tonight. We ought to have another beautiful day tomorrow morning. We'll see you back here at the Kodak Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta for day number 2 tomorrow morning.
Right on.
27th annual. It's been a quick 2 hours.
It has. Get up early, come out and join us in the morning, and if you can't do that, sit there comfortably on your couch or in your recliner or in the bed or whatever and watch our show tomorrow morning.
Lots of people, lots of balloons, lots of fun.
Buenos dias. Have a good day. Thank you for joining us all. I hope you tune in tomorrow, bright and early.